Welcome to Santa Fe. We're in this community that we've been building in all week long. It's a brand new community. It's only been here maybe 6 months. A lot of these families that we're building for have been here waiting for the last 6 months for us to arrive. They've moved from various other locations to this land that the government has made available. Many of them were squatters in other places, and so this is their first chance to own land and to have a house of their own. So we've been building for these families, and we have essentially doubled the size of this community. We're building 14 homes here, and there are two other churches here building two other homes as well. So that's 16 new homes in this brand new community in this 1 week that will radically change these families' lives. This morning, we want to give you a chance to get to know some of these families a little bit better through the eyes of some of our students and through the eyes of the camera. This week, we give students and adults a chance to grow in so many different ways. There's a chance for them to experience a humanitarian effort of coming down and serving these families, of building a home, of providing a family with something that there is no way they would have had without us.
And this is Luis. Hi. He's a father, and his wife's name is Laura, and he has a son, and his name is
Brandon.
And he's a motorcycle mechanic, and he used to live in San Diego, where he learned his trade. And due to a passport malfunction or error or whatever, he was sent back here, and he had to squat on some land in order to get by. And so now he's living in this Ford Bronco with his wife and son. Well, we're glad to be here and building a house for you. So
I'm so glad. I appreciate a lot. I appreciate a lot of you people. You're helping us.
My favorite thing about Mexico is just all the friendships we make here and how everyone gets the ability to leave their guard down, which isn't something that happens at home all the time. And just the opportunities we have to share and be open with each other helps us become closer to one another and also to God. And also the little Mexican children are so friendly and just, they're so full of hope. And it just makes me feel so happy to play with them and be here.
That whole drawing closer is part of our theme for this week. Our theme is draw near, go far.
We're here at the Orange Team House that was built last year with Lupita and her husband Ramon, who is a pastor in this house that we built. And the house was actually built for them so that they could have some sort of chapel or church here in the neighborhood. And 3 days a week, she runs a Kingdom Kids-like program where she provides all the activities and teaches all these children about Jesus. It's gotten to the point where it is so crowded in there, it's standing room only, but she's spreading the love of Jesus all over the neighborhood. We asked her what the story was with some of the other houses that we built last year, and she said, in many of them, when they have young children, they remain in the house, but once the children are grown, they tend to sell the house and move on and let another family move in. So it provides a starting or a foundation place for any families that are coming in. It's a springboard to a better way of life. So it's evidence that everything we do every year makes a huge difference in the lives of not just the people we build the house for, but people all over the community.
So when I first heard that some of the families in the past that we've built homes for, houses for, had been moving out of them and selling them, I was kind of bummed because I was like, we've been, you know, doing all this hard work and spending a week down here to make these houses for them. But then I realized that building these houses for these families are just the building blocks to moving on to better things, and they're the foundation for them having hope to have a better life and getting out of this city and out of this, out of these terrible conditions. So we never intended that this would be their permanent home.
This is my temporary home. It's not where I belong. Temporary home.
it's sort of strange at times that we have to go this far to come down here to Mexico to experience that nearness. But there is something that happens on this trip that doesn't happen when we're at home.
A lot of our education in La Mirinda is focused on teaching us how to build up our own lives by going to college and getting a job and working on our own self-interest. But coming to Mexico is a lot different. You know, we can always send money. We can send money to places like Haiti. But here we can come and look outside of ourselves and actually make a difference.
It's a check on yourself that when you come back, since you know the kind of person you can be, you come back with the renewed sense of that's who I want to be, and that's what I want to be like when I come back. And so I think what I take back is that outlook for myself is, how am I going to live differently? How am I going to live more fully when I come back home?
Serving others, glorifying God, it's the kind of life I want to live.
It's your life, what you gonna do? The world is watching you. Every day, the choices you make say what you are and who your heart beats for. It's an open door. It's your life. Are you who you always said you would be? With a sinking feeling.